Mucolytics are medicines that thin mucus, making it less thick and sticky and easier to cough up. They are used to treat respiratory conditions characterized by excessive or thickened mucus, such as a chesty, productive, cough. In this video, let's find out. What is mucolytics? Types of mucolytics. What is mucolytics used for? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking mucolytics? List of mucolytics. Types of mucolytics. Mucolytics divide into two subgroups. 1. Classic mucolytics. This subgroup includes N-acetylcysteine, carbocysteine, ergostine, and fudostine. Disulfide bonds are building blocks of many complex proteins, including mucus. Acetylcysteine, NAC, the prototype drug of this class, reserves a reducing ability and works by the thiol-disulfide interchange mechanism. The mucin polymers have cysteine residues throughout their structure. 2. Peptide mucolytics. In contrast to classic mucolytics, peptide mucolytics preserve active mucins. Peptide mucolytics target DNA polymers and F-actin links that tend to increase in purulent secretions. Dornase alpha and thymosin beta 4 are very useful in conditions such as cystic fibrosis. Types of mucolytics. Mucolytics divide into two subgroups. 1. Classic mucolytics. This subgroup includes N-acetylcysteine, carbocysteine, ergostine, and fudostine. Disulfide bonds are building blocks of many complex proteins, including mucus. Acetylcysteine, NAC, the prototype drug of this class, reserves a reducing ability and works by the thiol-disulfide interchange mechanism. The mucin polymers have cysteine residues throughout their structure. 2. Peptide mucolytics. In contrast to classic mucolytics, peptide mucolytics preserve active mucins. Peptide mucolytics target DNA polymers and F-actin links that tend to increase in purulent secretions. Dornase alpha and thymosin beta 4 are very useful in conditions such as cystic fibrosis. What is mucolytics used for? Providers use mucolytics to treat chronic, long-lasting, lung or breathing conditions that create thick mucus. These include cystic fibrosis, bronchiectasis, chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, COPD, emphysema, asthma. Contraindication. Due to its propensity to cause emesis, N-acetylcysteine is contraindicated in patients with peptic ulcers. It is also contraindicated in patients with esophageal varices and Mallory-Weiss tears due to similar reasons. It must be strictly avoided in patients who have had an anaphylactic reaction to the drug in the past. The only contraindication for Dornase alpha is known hypersensitivity to the drug in the past or if the patient is hypersensitive to Chinese hamster ovary, CHO, cell products. Carbocysteine is contraindicated in patients with active gastric ulceration. Side effects. Side effects of mucolytics include nausea or vomiting, diarrhea, rash, sore throat, loss of voice or change in voice, shortness of breath, dyspnea, chest pain. Mucolytics make it easier to clear mucus out when you cough. They don't necessarily make you cough more. List of mucolytics. There are a number of mucolytics available to prescribe in the UK. These include carbocysteine and ergostine. Both are available as capsules. Carbocysteine is also available as an oral liquid. Two other types of mucolytic are available to prescribe. They are called Dornase alpha and mannitol. These medicines are inhaled but are usually only prescribed for people with cystic fibrosis. That's all the information about mucolytics we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video to update more health information.